Hi, welcome to Programming with Mesh. In this session, we will get acquainted with the image and image background components and learn how to use them. In the previous session, we got acquainted with Modal, and using it, we created a custom alert. Now we want to show an image on the page according to user feedback. I created a folder called Assets and copied two images with the concept of done and error in it. Now in the part where we display the text of the success of the process, we put the error image by default, and if the user enters his name correctly, we display the done image. Here we use the image component and import it from the React Native library. Using source prop, we give it the address of our image. We use require in it. A dot and slash give us the path from the current folder. And two dots and a slash go back to a folder. Because the assets folder is in the current app.js path, we get to it from a dot and a slash. Then we enter the name of the file we want. As you can see, the image is displayed in a large size. So we use the style to give it the desired size. I also give it a margin to move away from the side components. As you can see, because the image itself is not a square, it doesn't fit perfectly into the square we defined. If we use the resize mode prop and give it a stretch value, the image will fit in the size we defined for it. Well, we copy this component to use it for another image. I put it under the text, and because the output here should be one element, I put them in a view. I also change the name of the image. Now by entering the name, the done image should be displayed. The image is not in the center, so I create a style for the view, such as the body style we created earlier. Well done, right? So far we have used the image locally. The currently supported formats are PNG, JPEG, BMP, GIF, WebP, and PSD only in iOS. In addition, iOS supports several raw image formats. Now suppose our image is an URL. Instead of require, we use URI and put the web address inside it. For example, I selected this image from a website and put its address. As you can see, if the device is connected to the internet, the image will load. Of course, you can use default source prop and show another image when the device's internet is down. For its value, you can use a local image like the source. You can use blur radius prop to blur the image. To place an image below the other elements, we use the image background component. I replace the main view with it to put an image in the background of the page. For example, I chose this breakwall. I put its address in the source prop. Of course, like the image component, you can also use local images. As you can see, the image is in the background. Well, in this part, the background image was covered, and the reason is that in style it's given a background color. If we delete it, we will see the background image. I changed this image to make the page components look better. So there we go, we got acquainted with the image and image background components. So in the next video, we create a custom component to prevent duplicate coding. Now if you enjoyed the video, please don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you in the next session.